Yeah, we sliding and gliding and we ain't hiding. It's your boy Snap Dog. And y'all know what it is, man. Hey, some of y'all might know me from. Yeah. But a lot of y'all, I know y'all know me from catching these fades or getting these hands. But guess what we doing, though? It's time we sit down and we talking with the dog, man. So come holler at me, man. Come rock out with me, man. Let me see what's up, man. Yeah! Yeah, y'all already know what it is, man. This is the first episode of Talking with the Dog, man. I appreciate y'all, man. Today's guest, man, we got Black Moses, man, and we got Big Bro, man. Big Hef in the building, man. What's going on with y'all boys? How y'all doing today?
What's up? What's up? What's the deal, Snap?
How y'all feeling,
talking
man?
Talking with the dog, man.
Talking with the dog, man.
We in Detroit now.
Yeah, we in the D with it, man.
Yo, Biddy.
Yeah, man. And y'all know we got my host, man. The boy.
He's here.
You know what I'm saying?
Come on, man. Come on, man.
So, yeah, man. How y'all liking the D? How the weather is, man? Y'all cold. This shit hit different.
Yeah, it's cold. But, you know, we, 2 hours away?
Yeah.
In Cleveland, Youngstown. So, you know, it ain't too much different, you know? Y'all like family.
Yeah.
Midwest, so,
yeah.
You know, I love y'all food, though. I ain't gonna lie. Y'all got
fuck
too
with
much
the food.
Hell
yeah. You fucking, what's your favorite one that you can fuck with?
I ain't gonna lie. I done went to so many different spots. I done hit a hibachi spot. A Mexican spot.
Oh, yeah.
Soul food spot.
Yeah.
Yeah, it's on the floor.
You fucking with Arabic food?
I need some spots. Y'all need to put me on or something. Oh,
you fucking with the Arabic food?
The what?
Arabic. Arabic. Middle Eastern food.
I don't know if I had it before.
We'll put you on after that. After this, we'll put you on.
Where is it to go?
Dearborn.
Dearborn.
Oh, yeah, it's literally everything in there. You'll think
they
you're
got they
overseas.
They own little city. They own little.
Yeah.
Wow. You rock with it? It's not.
Yeah. It took me years to eat it, man. I just tried it, and it, I was
scared.
Fucking with it. I was fucking with it.
It looks different. All this, it looked different, so you're scared.
I was fucking with it.
All, right.
All you want to eat is the same shit.
So, yeah, man, Black Moses, man, tell us about you, man, and your upcoming in Ohio, man.
Okay, yeah. I'm from Youngstown, Ohio, you know, a small city, you know, 2 hours from Detroit. You know, it's in Ohio, but it's a very, very small city, the trenches, you know. Not too many made it out.
It's active, though. You got to tell them it's active.
Yeah. It's super active. Like, people don't make it out.
Yeah.
Like, you feel me? It's a select few. Like, you count on one hand the amount of people that made it out of that city, you know? And shout out to my mama, the mafia. You know, she got me out of there early, got me to Cleveland. And that ain't too much better. But, you know, I was in the right position under my brother to, you know, try to stay focused and hoop. But, you know, my route changed and shit happened, you know.
And for the ones that don't, you know what I'm saying, don't know who your brother is, tell them who your brother is, you know what I'm saying,
so they can know. T-Rose, man, Terry Rozier.
Yeah, yeah. And that's big right there.
Yeah.
That's big right there to have a brother, like, you know, in the NBA, and you do the music, because it's like, you know, you would follow through the brother footsteps and want to hoop. So by you doing the music, man, and just, I see how he supports you, man. That's lit.
Yeah. He hands-on. He's super hands-on.
Yeah.
Yeah, with all type of support. But, you know, I got him on my tape.
Yeah, no, I listened to the tape. Yeah. I love the intro.
His name, TV B Neck. He the only feature on there, the seventh son.
Okay, so that was that song I heard then, because I was wondering who was on there.
Yeah, that Bulletproof Lack.
Yeah. Yeah. All right, so tell me what like, made you get into this music, and what moment did it take for you to know, like, all right, I got to take this shit serious, bro. Cause you've been around a lifestyle, you've been around the success shit. So what made you like, all right, man, I want to do this music shit, bro, and take this real deal serious and make my own way with this.
I ain't gonna lie to you, man. I say everybody around me for real.
Yeah.
Especially my big brother, like he really forced me.
Oh,
like you feel
that's
me?
Your motivation.
You know me, like. I'm a product, so I'm trying to get it any way I can and trying to make it happen. But my brother, he wanted me to be a rapper because it's people like Miles Bridges on his team and him, and they in the studio, they making music. And he know I got it. I got the swag. I got the look. I'm doing everything a rapper say he do. I've been doing this since I was 14. I've been having the swag. So it's just like he wanted to put a mic on me. And I ain't gonna lie, big bro, like where he put it on me. He like influenced me to do it.
He was in the studio with you?
He actually got in the studio before me. I made a song when I was younger, but he been making music.
Okay.
So he done he really done put it on me and like made me rap. A lot of my people around me was telling me like, bro, you a rapper, bro. You look like a rapper. You act like a rapper. You move like one. And you do what a rapper do, so you might as well just rap.
How did that feel when you be seeing like some of the NBA dudes like rocking with your music? Because that's big, bro. You feel me?
That's major, yeah. Some of the players I looked up to growing up, you know? So, man, it's really, you know, it is what it is. It's an unbelievable feeling for real, especially right. with the ones I used to grow up playing the video games.
Yeah,
that shit different, you know?
So how,
It's mad love.
You and Hef relationship, man, like, you know?
Hef, my dog, man. Big dog. You know, I met Hef, what? How long ago was that, Hef, we met?
Like couple years ago.
Yeah, sure. on our first tour, I reached out to him, so, you know, I can, like, get the feel of being an artist and, like, get some more exposure and stuff like that. And he was right. He hit me right back. He was ready to work, get back working, even though he just came off a tour.
Yeah,
but he was ready to hop back on the tour and, you know?
Yeah. For sure.
I got hip to him from my homie 55 Bags from CMG.
Yeah, shout out Bags.
He sent me a record. I'm like, who is that record you got this joint? He's like, oh, that's Black Moses, man. That's Terry Brother. We got like 4 or 5 joints together. I was like, we got to lock in.
So, Hef, you tell me, how did you get started in the industry?
Man, I always like locked in with like a lot of DJs. I always wanted to be a part of the industry. I just didn't know how. I feel like a lot of people, they don't know how or what they gonna do. And then, man, I've been connected. Like, I used to deal with DJ Who Kid in New York.
Mm-hmm.
And then my best friend is from Detroit. So I used to invite a lot of underground rappers from Detroit to Cleveland to perform. And some of those members end up becoming D12. So it just turned me all the way up. That's why I started seeing the whole country grinding. And, I ain't looked back since then.
Yeah. What was your biggest lessons that you learned in the music game and industry that kind of stuck with you?
Man, I think like one of the first joints, bro, is when I had like Mike Jones and then when they was younger. Like I was coming off the 50 G unit wave or whatever. I used to have like Mike Jones and when they was underground rappers. Mm-hmm. So not signing them at the time. You feel me?
So you missed the opportunity.
Yeah, I missed.
How you feel about that?
So it was like I had Mike Jones, Paul Wall, Chameleonaire.
Damn. God damn it. That's everybody.
I had that whole underground Houston wave, but I had like an OG.
Yeah.
That knew better.
Yeah.
But he didn't tell me at the time.
Ooh.
So I missed about 4 or 5 platinum selling artists that probably would have changed the whole trajectory of my career.
Mm-hmm.
But it just taught me a lesson to handle my business first instead of being a fan of the music.
Okay.
Yeah, so I learned the hard way.
Yeah, you learned
and a lot of commas got missing, you know?
Yeah. So, Black Moses, like, a lot of people, they use music for therapy. Like, what was one of your sessions where you know, how you get through your shit? Like, what is it, somebody that you listening to? Is it something that you go do? You know what I'm saying? Like, what is it to get you in that mode?
I definitely use music for therapy, but to get me in that mode, I gotta like have my people around me and like be in a good headspace and be vibing and like just be ready to just have a lot of stuff to talk about. Like I don't like overstacking in the studio. I like to get out here first.
Yeah.
And then like
have something to talk about.
You know?
Gotta go, you like to tell the real deal, like go do some shit and you know, go back to that studio, like, yeah, this
and
just
tell
happened.
Exactly how it went.
I be seeing you on the jets, you on all that, so you get to pop your shit on a motherfucker, you know
type,
what I'm saying?
Yeah,
to where a motherfucker understand, like, yeah.
Yeah, it's there.
Yeah, no, that's definitely, that's dope. Bro. That's dope. So, Hef, like, what connect you to an artist to, like, want to take an artist under your wing and help them grow with their career?
Man, it just conversations. I'm an energy person. So, if I'm vibing, if I'm and somebody got a story that I can relate to or I can connect to, then that's when I reach out to them. Or if I see somebody moving, like, you know, I see a guy moving, I'll be like, I like the way, you know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
Homie rocking. I like, you know what I'm saying? I like what he stand for. And once I lock in with him that way, they'll be like, all right, like, it's time to open some doors for him or show him what touring like or show him what doing big stages like or something like that or show him what radio like and how it can impact their career. Because a lot of times people just don't know.
It's just a gut feeling. It ain't about numbers for real?
Nah, because you can make those if it's right. You know what I'm saying? Because one, like, we in a TikTok era now. So shit, one line can change the whole, you know what I'm saying, the whole vibe of a song, making sure people know what the song is or, you know, so... But it's just really the vibe of an artist, because like everybody got different energy.
Yeah, I think that, that's what matters the most too.
Some niggas got too much shit going on too, though.
For sure.
I'd be like, bro, I might have to back up off you for a minute. Cause, and then, you know.
It get like that. It do. And then it's like you don't want to put yourself in, you know what I'm saying, some shit that you can't control because you got a family too, man.
Yeah, so definitely. So it just be the energy, bro. Like it be the energy and then just lock in. And if like you always know, like, the niggas that's really on it, like, man, I'm gonna be a star. I'm gonna be a star. Like everybody said, until it's time to do the work. Snap, you know what the work be like.
And I know what that work be like, man. And it's crazy because little do they don't know, you feel me? You watch me come from a hype man into an artist, man. And my first time ever getting on the road and just being around the music was with you and Cash Paid. Like I ain't had nowhere of nothing.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And I remember just telling bro, like, even at every event, like, man, I don't care. And it was nice crowds, too, but I was telling him, like, I don't care if it's two people in the crowd. We're going to perform like it's 50,000.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
I always call it, like, the training. I'll be like, bro, once you going to see the growth. And then, like, if you're doing 50 people, you're doing 100 people, then it's 5, then it's 1,000. Next thing you know, you're in a stadium of 20,000 people. And, like, facts. You know what to do and how to move on. Our niggas don't even know how to move on stage.
Facts.
You know what I'm saying?
Facts. Because a lot of... So what you feel about, like, Black Moses, what you feel about the performance things? Like, is you, like, one of them laid-back artists on performing? Or you like fuck that, nigga. I'm about to steal a show, nigga. I'm about to rock out.
I'm trying to show them, like, I really got that, like, that Tupac 50 Cent, like, that...
Yeah.
That performance. Yeah. You know, ego in me. I'm trying to show them I'm going to rock out.
Yeah. So you just got the new project, man, that you just dropped, man. And what's the feedback? How you feeling about that? Is this your first project that you dropped?
Yep. This is actually my first project.
Tell them where to go get it. What's the name, by the way?
All platforms. You can go get it. It's called Wick Block Volume 1. You can find me at Black Moses with 2 Ks. You know, I split the Red Sea. That's what Black Moses did, you know?
That's power right there.
Yeah, that's power. That's powerful. But you can find that on all platforms. And I just dropped one of my latest singles called Way We Live. It's a hot single. I'm letting y'all in on the way I live. Go check it out. It's the first song on the tape. And you know, they've been taking the tape. They've been taking it straight, man. They've been, especially my fans, my people, they love it, you know?
Yeah.
And they kind of favored the songs that I knew they were. The bangers that I knew was bangers, you know, but.
What's your favorite one?
Ramsey's Tall.
Why is that?
I made that by my brother that passed. You know, that's why it's called Wick Block Volume 1. Because that's my brother named Wick. And then I did the whole thing, like, on the block where he passed away at.
Oh, that's deep. So, like, I can definitely relate to that, man. Lose my twin brother. That's what made me start the music. So you can definitely understand how that is, man. So how that shit just be, like, feeling, you know what I'm saying, when you doing this music. Like, because, like, with me, I'll accomplish a lot of shit, and I'll be like, damn, like, it feel good, but then I'd be like, if bro was here, like, I feel like I have more joy.
Damn, he supposed to be right there, ain't he?
Yeah.
Right on your side.
Facts.
But it's like, I take it with a grain of salt, because I feel like, you know, everything happened for a reason. When he passed, it kind of changed, like, my whole family. Like, we treat him like a god. We look at him as like a god. And, like, he made everybody better, like, mentally, physically, spiritually. Like, right after he died, that's when my brother signed for $68 million. Like, you would think it's some crazy stuff, but, like, God really gonna test you before, like, he bless you.
Facts.
And you're gonna need them people on the other side to guide you, like, spiritually.
Facts.
Like, cause life ain't no joke, man.
Yeah, nah, it get deep out here, bro.
I need him up there. I know I want him here so bad, but I can't be a crab in a bucket.
Nah, for sure, man.
I need him.
So that's the main push we keep you going, bro. That's how it is with me. So that's why you wear red a lot?
Yeah.
That's crazy, because that's why we wear orange. You know what I'm saying?
Oh,
so that's dope as hell. I can stand on that one all the way. Like, everything I do is, it got to be orange, bro. Right. Like, fuck the bullshit, it got to be orange. So it's like
red and green.
Yeah. Red and green. See, a lot of motherfuckers were thinking we was gangbanging with the orange. I'm like, nah, this for bro. You feel me? Right. And bro. Then with the Bronco shit, they thought it was Denver Broncos. I'm like, nah, his real name is Bronco.
And their color's orange, too.
Yeah. His favorite color was orange. But he liked the orange pop. Like, all he do is drink orange pop. So that's what made us like, all right, bet. But orange it looked like we was fucking with the Denver Broncos because it's orange and his real name Broncos. Bronco, so, right. I just had a motherfucker at the Lions game. Like, yeah, I like that Denver Broncos. I said, nah. Flipped it back. That like, that motherfucker said, RP Bronco. You know what I'm saying? So, nah, man, that shit, I can rock with that, bro. And I understand your pain on that shit, man. Because when you in that studio, bro, that shit real therapy for real, bro.
Definitely.
So,
therapy.
Nigga definitely understand that shit, man. How that shit go and all that, bro. So, yeah, definitely understand.
You know, I feel you too. It's, you know. It's a big boomerang.
Yeah, facts. So, Hef, man.
Yeah.
What's up, man?
Man, I'm trying to get to
it. Man, you done did a lot of things, man.
I'm trying to get to it.
You done did a lot of things, man. You really a legend, man. And you come to the D, man, and you always show love, bro. That's
for sure.
That's what I do like about you, bro. You know what I'm saying? Like,
sure.
You really embrace the artists and try to help artists, bro.
Yeah.
Like, I can ask, like, just you and Black Moses first run, right?
Yeah.
And I can literally tell
second,
this a good one right here, bro. Like, you a good one, bro. And you going
appreciate that.
You feel me? Keep doing you. Keep being you, man, with your pure heart, bro.
I remember seeing you when we brought Young Thug to town. And he was the first call he made when he touched down.
That was big.
And I was like, I'm like, how you know Snap? You know
at the shoe store?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Oh shit. Yeah.
It was just crazy on that with Thug, man. Free Thug too, man. You know what I'm saying? He paid for my eyes and shit. You know what I'm saying? Like that was
he what?
He paid for my eyes. Like I had a fucked up vision.
Oh,
like,
he did that?
Yeah, like on some just
randomly at 4 a.m.
Random shit. Like
he liked that, I heard.
Yeah, no, that's the most purest, like I know they don't say nobody perfect, but that's like the most perfectest motherfucker I've ever met. Like
it's crazy.
He care about everybody, bro. He look out for everybody, and he give you game. Like
he stand on that, too.
Sure. He stand on that family shit, man. I just remember him telling me, like, right after my fight, he like, man, how much you want to sign with me?
Mm.
And then that's when the Rico came up.
Mm.
Hey, we got a little break.
Hey, man, we about to go into the commercial break, man. Hey, this is the first episode, man. We talking with the dog, man. So I need y'all to come back. We will be right back. So tell a friend, tell your grandma, tell Uncle Tommy with the oxygen machine, man. Come back to the Snap Dog Live. We talking with Snap Dog, man. So tune back, man. We will be back after this commercial break. Yeah!
Yeah, what's the deal? It's your boy Snap Dog. And shout out to our official sponsor, Leaf and Bud. My boy Mark, man, you're doing your big things in here. You're doing your ones and twos, man. Big cannabis out here, man. Y'all see them all over the billboards. Y'all see them all in the streets. Y'all see them on the trucks. Y'all see them all on the internet, man. Hey, Mark, keep doing your thing, man. Y'all go shop with Leaf and Bud. One of the best in the city. Go shop. Yeah.
Our assignment is simple. Crack down on all the drag races in the city. And I can't do this all by myself. I need you, Carter.
It's gonna be easier said than done. Once I get behind the wheel, man, there's no catching them.
Who said anything about catching
them? We have Ace Rebels conducting illegal activity drivers all around the city. Robbery, death, extortion. Ace splits profits. Brother Leonard.
Man, these broke-ass niggas think they can steal from me? Man, put 500 on these niggas' head, dog. I want these niggas dead or alive. First off, I ain't running from no niggas. Second off, you getting dropped cause he your nigga. I ain't caught a case shit cause I can't witness. Little bro, come and slide down your
throat. Not a lot of driving all, but what y'all need is a hitman.
Street racing, burnouts, and donuts continue to be a major concern for the community. Seven miles in Greenfield, someone poured gasoline and lit a circle of fire in the middle of the intersection.
So who is this? We have Kevin Johnson, aka 392, King Kev.
Thank you.
talking with this. Talking with the dog, man. We back. My fault, man.
Talking with the dog, man.
So, man, how y'all rocking with the show, man? How y'all feeling it, man?
I love the energy, man.
You love the energy. I got a brand of energy, man. You know I'm too laid back, man. I got a brand of energy, man. We got Black Moses in the building, man.
What's up,
we got
brother?
A dope, talented artist in the building, man. Man, you got your first single, man. The Way We Live, man. Tell me about that single. What was the creation of that song, man? Like, what was going through your brain when you made that shit?
Oh, man, Way We Live. It was a late night, of course. I was in Miami. You know, I was with my engineer, Maury. Shout out D-Bake. He was recording me at the time. And we be going in late, man. I be going in late. And I was actually, this when I'm in my mode. You know, I got the studio all red at the time. And I just hopped in that mode. And I just, you know, I was freestyling. And sometimes, like, I get in modes where I tell bro, like, no hook this song, because I'm just feeling different.
Facts.
I just want to keep going. So I just keep going. And basically, I just wanted to let them know, like, how we live, like, basically, we had a lot going on.
Cause you live a little ass life, you know.
We just threw a
ice, fucking with the owls, you know, counting them proud, you know what I'm saying?
But we just threw like a freak neek, you know. I threw a freak neek. I was the host, you know.
So oh shit!
I'm trying to tell these folks exactly what's going on and let them know like this how we living. This the way I live.
Yeah. So how was that freak neek? I'm saying how was it?
Was crazy.
What type of ones you had in there?
You know, I got a playback for
Africans, Jamaicans, Mexicans. You got it all type of flavors.
Man, a little bit of more. Oh,
what's the freak neek? I know it's some.
Yeah, for the people who don't know, what's a freak neek?
A freak neek is basically like a hood female party, like on some 4th of July. Like they wear like the spray painted t-shirts and all the short shorts.
So it's just a party.
Yeah, it's for the
like block
freak
party
neek.
Type shit.
It's for the hood freak neek females.
The one that's gonna
But I threw it myself with all females, shit. So it's just
so. Let me ask this: you threw that motherfucker yourself, right? Like you got a girl, bro. I don't want to get you in trouble.
I ain't got no girl right now.
You ain't got no girl. Y'all hear that? All y'all bad bitches, he ain't got no girl. So hit the DM. Go suck hard dick and bubble gum. Yeah, yeah. That's what he on. He's a star. That's what we doing. Don't be scared, motherfucker. Yeah, freak nigga it all the way.
Yeah.
So like, you ain't had none of your little, you know, hoes getting out of line, like trying to fight each other because you that nigga, bro. Hey. So what going on?
You know how that shit go. They might try to, but I gotta keep them in line, you know. I come from my granddad was a pimp, so
push your peas.
Come on, man.
Bring back that money, so I can have some for you, bitch.
My granddaddy was a pimp, so I get it from him, you know. I gotta keep him in line, keep him in check, so. If they see me doing this, they know it ain't about nothing. I'ma see you later.
Yeah. You know? So did you have any? Cause I know how this shit be, bro. I know how shit be. Did you have any type of ones that were trying to come and you like, nah, this bitch can't come through. Like this bitch crazy. I know this one. She toxic. She can't come through. Hey, big bro, don't
you definitely got it like that? Cause she love me too much, so she definitely can't come. Cause she just gonna make it. She gonna make it hot. She gonna try to be on me. I can't have her here. This ain't her type of party. So she's done. You know how it be.
Yeah.
All right,
so
man.
Black them out.
Yeah. So let back. Like I said, all you freaky hoe, get in this DM. Go suck them hard dick bubblegum.
_black.
Yeah, that's what we on, man. But let's get into this single, man. The Way We Live, bro. Off the project, man. Let's tune in right now to the single, man. Y'all go get that. Y'all go stream that. Go turn that up. You know what I'm saying? The Way We Live. If you living a boss life, this shit for you. And if you a broke nigga trying to live a boss life, it's still for you, nigga. Yeah.
Come on, man.
Hey, it's Maury.
My brother, that's who. What up, bitch? They got me sleep. Snitched up in the gang cause he was in it too deep. Please don't put my name in the sun, my brother them gon' creep. 100 shots a piece, hopping out that Jeep, we walk down on feet. Brody cash out on that ghost, so let's make a toast. Finna throw a freak me, go up, cause I'ma be the host. Post it up, on the south side, 105 for Lowe's. All we know is get the bread, but don't never low. All we know is get the bread, but we don't never lack. I can't lie, I like the rap, but I love it. Brody, he been stepping on that crack, gon' break his mama back. I be bullying at my opps hood, it's bulletproof to lack. GMB the lifestyle, you see it be awesome. Creeping in his bushes, late night just like a possum. TBB the lifestyle, you see the extravagant. Reach around my neck and I'ma blow just like a candle lit. I ain't tripping what God put me through, I can handle it. Love withdraws, I'm broken hearted, but I manage. Freak just want a nut, reminding me of Sandy. Told him on the coming handy. GMB in Paris, we the trending topic. Hell yeah, we the so we gotta pop it. Long live Tate. myself, we grew up playing Xbox. Brody got $1 million plan right on his desktop. Brody got a 12 gauge pump, but he ain't breastfeed. I'm the first to get up to the worm, I know the next need it. Oh, you got pretty feet, put them on my, like it's Halloween, baby, do a trick for a treat. Talking like the hot, we chase them off the block. Oh, you got French tips, put them on my, all my smoke is out of gas. Baby girl, she hated when I said, don't touch my pop. Keep going, keep flowing, see this complete. Damn dollar with the blitz, I can score from D. I just put the top tier model with Marnie on my feet. Way deep up, I'm the hardest in the industry. I just heard through the grapevine, they wanna finish me. Feds been lurking, taking pics, they wanna sentence me. I told Bae that we forever, we got good chemistry. I'ma add this money up, like it's mathematics. Brody in the trap, he making flips just like it's acrobatic. Like we on the carpet with our socks, yeah, we want you static. Pop it, and sipping, it's a f***ing habit. Singing y'all the range just like a bunny rabbit. I don't wanna f*** up on that b***h because she funny acting. Broke, Disney for some clout, ain't got no reaction. Put them headphones on and get up in that mode. My uncle was the realest ever, till he took his toes. All we know is get them packs in and get them f***ing gone. All we know is run that bag up and let it f***ing smoke. Hate a b***h, you act bad, but she really basic. Give me the best of my life, only way I chase it. That feeling that you give me when I'm with you, I just can't replace it. Put it in the backseat, I feel like I'm Stacy. We be giving out them slugs and we ain't never had no hugs. On the block, post it up with, and I'm showing love. On the block, post it up with, and I'm showing love. On the block, post it up with, and I'm serving. Living life like a thug, posted with the plug. Living life like a thug, and I'm showing love.
Yeah, man, we is back, man, talking with the dog, man. Y'all just listen to my boy Single, man. Let us know how y'all fucking with it, man. Hey, man, shout out to our number one sponsor, man. Leaf and Bud, man. Mark, man, I see you are in Tanner City up, man. You all over the billboards. You're doing your thing, man, in the cannabis business, man. So I want to give a big shout out to Mark, man. Leaf and Bud, man, if you're trying to get high and you're trying to get fly, go see Leaf and Bud, man, and you going to understand what's going on.
I want to do that. I want to do a cannabis tour.
You want to do cannabis?
Yeah.
Man, you got to have that good weed, man. You got to have that good weed, man. Sure. Hey, Leaf and Bud got it. I don't smoke, but Leaf and Bud got it, man. But, hey, man, you know I gotta fuck with my dog, man. My dog, yeah. He talking that language for me. He say he into the pimp shit, man.
Yeah, been pimping since.
I need to let it loose. Yeah, they got that shit, gang.
Oh, bro.
So, tell me, gang.
Hi, Kane.
How you treat these toxic bitches, gang?
Like, all these toxic bitches, man. We gonna get into it.
Because you know some of these hoes, they fall in love with you, bro. So how you gotta learn how to separate that and tell that bitch, go get that money, young bitch. You do not put a fall in love with me. Right. This is a business.
Let's get straight into it then, man. These toxic hoes, man. How treat these toxic bitches that just want to be all up under a nigga and ain't chasing no paper. Like, yeah, man, them hoes gotta go, man. Cause the last, I ain't gonna lie, I've been falling victim, bro. You know them bad bitches, man. Them hoes do it, bro.
Man, what? But you been feeling sorry for the bitches, man?
Man, for this one little hoe, man, she got under my little skin, man.
She had that.
I'm talking about that wet shit, man. That shit that
yeah,
ocean,
shit
that
make your toes go like this, huh?
The one to do it to you, Fi. But I ain't gonna lie, man. She had to kick the road, you know, hit the curb. And she like way feel some type of way and some good shit happened, so you know.
She sound like that one that got that power where she could text your phone and make you feel sorry and say, bring your ass over here tonight.
She might.
Oh, fuck.
You know something, bro. Hey, you know something.
Yeah.
Hey, but ever since that, it's been tight for these hoes. Like, you know, I'm back on my pimp shit. A hoe can't get no love out of nigga no more. No. Unless she the one. Unless it's Bonnie and Clyde, like a situation. Like,
yeah, yo.
Other than that, I'm focused. I'm on my grind. And I've been pimping since Big Pimping. Big Pimping.
So my thing is, with the hoes, because it's like, you know what I'm saying? They do their thing or whatever. But is you, I know, understand you making a hoe go get the bag. But is you making these hoes support that music, though?
Man, of course.
You know,
man,
what I'm saying?
If you fuck with me, you got to support it. All my hoes, you know, from the baddest to the hoodest, they got to post that. They got to show that love.
So you got
know
a bottom
that they
bitch.
Fucked up by Moses. Yeah, you know.
Yeah.
I'm a savage. I can't give up on my hood, ho.
Yeah. Boy, she going to text you like, I sent that motherfucking lie with Snapdog, nigga. You got me fucked up, nigga. Tape ain't getting dropped no more.
Hey, you know they is. Hey, but I'm going to play it how I play.
The girls, where,
you know?
The, where the money's at with the music, you know what I'm saying?
Facts.
Yeah.
If you got the girl following, that's it. They're the ones that they're paying for shit. They're buying whatever the fuck buying you put out shirts, just because, you know
make,
what I'm saying?
I'm trying to make the music for them. We got to make a song for them.
Nah, we got to. But see, you got to understand, nigga, you got the name Black Moses, nigga. So these hoes got to worship the motherfucking ground you walk on, man. They got to worship that motherfucker.
They
got to
touch
them
knees.
Like,
man,
if they ain't on that, nigga, you got to kick them to the curb. Boop! Get the fuck on. I don't straight give a up, fuck man about you.
I'm feeling that.
You know what I'm saying? You got to let them know. You got to put the foot down, man, because these hoes, man, these hoes that try to get with us and, you know, try to, you know, jeopardize shit and do little lame ass shit when they get mad and shit. Number one thing, bitch gotta have respect for you. Cause if a bitch don't got respect, then you're through, my nigga.
You're
and
through.
I ain't going for that, nigga.
You're through. You heard my brother
on a bitch.
What you, what you think?
Respect, you gotta hit the deck, huh?
Oakland pimp culture, Chicago pimp culture, or Detroit pimp culture? Which one?
Man, I say Oakland, bro.
Oakland go crazy still.
Oakland go crazy, man. That's where that's where it's at. Oakland. See, Oakland, you got the loyal ones in Oakland.
Yeah.
Like, you'll find a bitch that make, you know what I'm saying, bitch will make 100K, you know what I'm saying? She gonna bring you that 100K. She not gonna bring you 99, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
Or 80, you know what I'm saying? Or
Oakland
dub.
Like
this,
though.
You know, nah,
thing.
Oakland, nigga, you'll have an Oakland bitch that come grab you, nigga,
yeah,
and say, hey, nigga, I'm trying to put that bag in your pocket. You know what I'm saying? Like,
with a whole
Chicago, you gotta worry about that bitch pulling up with a switch.
Right.
She might shoot you. Like, you might play with that bitch the wrong way.
Gotta watch
Detroit,
time,
you know what I'm saying? I love my Detroit woman, but if you got, I ain't gonna hold you up. You got a Detroit motherfucker bitch that make 50, 60,000, that bitch gonna tell you she made 12. And she gonna find a reason to get into it with you and get the fuck on.
Right.
Like, nigga, I'm done with you. That's how you know that bitch up. You know what I'm saying? Call the Jack boys, rob that bitch, get that money on back, bitch.
We need it, bitch.
Was,
we need it right back, bitch.
Yeah, yeah. Can't but the Oakland, that. The Oakland, man, they understand the game and they know about it, man. So it's like, they gonna treat a nigga better. You know what I'm saying? They gonna treat a nigga with love and respect.
Shout out Oakland.
And about that, you know what I'm saying? I didn't.
Crazy.
I know a lot of Oakland women, you know what I'm saying? They ain't scared either to tell you. Like, look, nigga, what I do, nigga. I'm trying to get money with you. You know what I'm saying? A Detroit bitch, she wanna say, I wanna get money with you. And then when you get the money on and y'all living that good life, and then you get another bad one, you know what I'm saying? Nah, she wanna get all in her feelings and all that.
Cause there's no money in the city.
Yeah.
Cali, they see money.
Nah, nigga, it's money in the D, nigga.
Nah, I feel you. I'm not saying there's no money.
Need they, we suck.
Hey, compared to Cali,
it's big pimping down here.
Yeah, it's don't get no come on, nigga. I ain't gonna hold you up. I ain't trying to put y'all on Front Street, but it's your kind that's spending the money.
Yeah.
What the? Come on, man.
Yeah. Yeah. You talking the strip clubs going ding ding ding.
Y'all be
ding
in Dubai
man, on the logo.
What? Not you.
Well, not me.
We know not you, but them niggas
over there running away from their wives,
man,
and shit. Bro, yeah, I feel this.
They taking them to Dubai. They got fire wire.
You like one of the only Midwest niggas that has Chicago on your side, bro. Like, how you fuck you get Chicago to ride with
you?
You
know what's so crazy, bro? Because, like, shout out to Dex Osama, Free Yeah Jordan. You know, them was the first, like, two drill rap niggas that came from the city. So when they paid the way, that's when I started rapping. And that's when I linked with, you know, shout out to my brother Deep Potts. You know what I'm saying? I linked with him.
Uh-huh.
And, like, the shit, the way he got it going, like, crazy. And then niggas was doing background checks on me, like, is he like that? Is he laying like that? Is he really like that? Yeah, nigga, I'm like that. Nigga, I'll railroad your ass. Play with me if you want to. I'll flatline your punk ass, nigga. Yeah, on that type of time.
Yeah.
So when niggas did their background check, bro, and they like, man, that nigga thorough. Chief Key reached out to a nigga, then Dirk reached out to a nigga. And it was up from there, you know what I'm saying? And
you
Chicago
like
embraced.
You, like, the crazy part, most, I don't know if these listeners know, but you got Dirk, you got Baby. You got, like, a lot of big-ass motherfucking niggas that fuck with you.
I
crazy.
Yeah, Dirk, Baby, Snoop, Fetty Wap, Casanova,
Shaq.
That's what being thorough gets you.
Drake, Thug.
Yeah.
But Shaq's a big one.
Shaq.
They say that's what being thorough gets you, huh?
Man, y'all, no, I ain't, you know what I'm saying? I've been thorough, man, just being myself, bro.
Yeah.
And they fucking with me, man. And that shit mean a lot, man. Because it's like, dog, you know, I'm a hood nigga, bro. I never would have thought, you know what I'm saying, I'd be where I'm at. You know, so, like I said, I come from being a hype man, so I never I think I be right here and turned
that's
up, you know
crazy,
what I'm saying?
And that say a lot, bro, for you to even be a hype man.
Yeah.
A lot of people got too much pride.
Oh, no, man. You know me, man. I'm going to pop my shit. We going to get on. We going to do our motherfucking thing. You know what I'm saying? And the bitches, like I said, hit my nigga DM. He trying to see what the Detroit hoes like. You know what I'm saying? Had them toes done. You know what I'm saying?
Definitely
fresh white.
Toes,
how you like them? How you like them, bro?
Man,
you,
I want
you,
some,
like, you,
I like
you like caramel.
Shit. Show me
you
different.
Like yellow.
I want to see some shit that I ain't seen before. If you got your nails done, I want some shit that I ain't never seen it before. Sparkly, glow in the dark. or French tip or like some different gold, French tip.
Yeah, it sound like right foot fetish.
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, you got that foot fetish.
Yeah,
hey, they got me.
Hey, big ass, bro. He come back home, make sure he sleep with you at your crib, bro. Cause his bitch is about to try to kill him when he go back to the city. Oh, nigga, you on the, you talking with the dog? You talking shit?
Come on.
Hey, y'all better stay in place. You feel me? You know what I'm saying? Like my dog said, man, he trying to get some. What type of women that you like though? Like you like the black thing, you like the caramel, you like the foreign, like you like the Oreo and dip. Like what you want?
What he say? I ain't got no type.
Bad bitches is the only thing that I like. Yeah.
I really ain't got no type, five, but if she bad, I'm digging her. You know? All
right, let me ask you this question, nigga. Name one bitch that you want to hit from the industry right now.
Ooh,
like one, I'm talking about. You want to take her through there?
Do it like that. Right, he gonna do it like that. Ooh,
take her through there. Let that bitch know you trying to get some right now. You trying to get between them legs right now, nigga. Chicken and turkey, bitch. Yeah.
Like Moses way.
You might not know her though. This.
I know all them bitches.
You know every bitch.
I know all them.
It's not be knowing, bro.
She an actor.
I got a girl now, but
she an actor though.
She an actor.
Actor.
Ooh, we them actors be freaky.
Freaky.
What's her name?
Her name.
What's she playing?
What show?
What's she playing? Like what?
Jenna Ortega.
What? Oh, what show she in?
Where she in?
Hey, stop. Hey, stop. Jenna Ortega, man. Hey.
Jenna Ortega's the
I'm
show?
I'm different, man. Jenna Ortega. I'm fucked up by Ortega, some shit like that.
Hey, shorty, whatever Jenna your name Ortega. Is, nigga, you hear my mans. He trying to get some of that. So fuck your boyfriend who you with. Come over here with the shit. Fuck you talking about, man.
Straight up.
On God. Boy. Hey, Hef, man, I got a real deal question, man. We call this the doghouse question, man.
Sure.
Before I end my show, I always hear he say, I'm sorry. Nigga, how you pimping and telling the bitch you sorry, nigga? Huh? You're about to be a
pimp.
Hey, you
got to see her.
Yeah. Oh, no, he ain't get her yet. You ain't get her yet. You got to keep it player. Yeah, once you hit, you got that's how I do it. Once you go snap, ain't no going back. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, you know, I'm already cuffed up. You know, I can't do shit. That shit dead. But, Hef, man, I got a question for you, man. For all the artists out there and for everybody out there, man, this is the doghouse question right here. What do you pick, independent or with a label? And why? Yeah, that's a hard one, boy. Okay. That's a hard one, boy.
Yeah. I mean, but you know, you've been on both sides.
Yeah, yeah.
I like the major because they show you the path and the blueprint to get to the bread.
Yeah.
And once you learn how to get that bread and you find your whatever your niche, your pocket is, you can eat forever.
Yeah.
You can eat, like, you know what I'm saying? Like you can really make money off touring, off merchandise, off like your persona, whatever you want to do, you know?
So,
if it's
you saying label.
I'm saying indie, but I respect what they teach you.
Facts.
For the, you know what I'm saying?
You're saying indie because you know it already.
Yeah. Like indie, I could do for the rest of my life, hands closed. You know what I'm saying? Like eyes closed, I could do that shit for the rest of my life.
Yeah.
But I like what they teach you and the exposure you get on a major.
So for someone that doesn't know what you know, you probably tell them to go the major way.
Yeah, for sure. All
right.
Because, you know, you got to learn.
Okay, like, but you still got to let these rappers know because these niggas be on this motherfucker crying like hoes when they sign that deal and they get that big check. And then when they run through that money, they be, man, my label don't want to. Would you tell these people what the rules of that? You got to make that money back, bro.
You got to make the money back. And, like, that bread ain't for you to fuck off and buy a whole bunch of shit with.
Yeah,
it's
hear
for
that.
You to keep, like, you're supposed to maintain your, like a year and a half. That's you supposed to live off that shit for a year and a half. Most niggas blow their shit.
You gotta pay it back time.
Most niggas blow their shit in like, nigga, they be
a month.
Yeah.
Hey man, y'all here, man. We got Black Moses, man. Big Hef, man. Yeah. Y'all heard what he said, man. Yeah. Y'all heard what he said at the end. Go get the tape, man. Y'all heard my man say he pimping. So let's get in here and do our thug thizzle. You feel me? We just wrapped it up, man, with the first episode, man, of Talking with the Dog, man. We will be back on another episode, and I need y'all to tune in, man. We sliding and gliding, and we ain't hiding on Jesus, Sandal Jacks, my mama and them. Hey, son, out guns off, you scared, stay your bitch ass in the house. Ain't no way, boy. Ain't no way that ain't Gated Dog his own podcast, nigga. The hottest podcast in the motherfucking world, nigga. And Earl said it, nigga. Uncle Earl, motherfucker.
Hey, come on, man.